Okay, so yesterday, this is actually being filmed on Sunday, it'll go up Monday, but yesterday was the last day for deliveries for Tesla in the state of Colorado. Unfortunately, Colorado doesn't allow deliveries on Sunday. All car manufacturers are closed.
Yeah, it's like that in a bunch of states. I don't think I've ever lived in a state where they had car sales on a Sunday. But when I talk to other people in other states, they're like, "What? Why can't you sell cars on Sunday?" But it's just an old law that they're not allowed to do that just because you're supposed to have the day off. And
It's stupid in my opinion.
the good thing though is if you ever do go to a regular car dealership, you can actually, that's the one day of the week that you can go to the car dealership and not be hounded by salesmen.
That is very true.
So that's the only good thing about it.
So we actually decided to join forces with Tesla and help volunteer our time and do some deliveries for new owners and give them the walkthrough. Obviously, we were not allowed to do paperwork or anything like that. That is Tesla employees only, but we were able to do walkthroughs and we have had a lot of experience with
Yeah, we,
Teslas.
I mean, even right before we went out there, we actually went out on Friday evening and took delivery, and we saw some volunteers out there already. We actually got paired up with a regular Tesla employee who went ahead and showed us ours. Thanks, Derek. It was really ironic to have Derek give us do delivery of our new Model 3. So that was cool. But anyways, we went out there first thing on Saturday morning on the 29th, last day for Tesla deliveries in Colorado, and there was already a bunch of people there. There was already a bunch of owner volunteers there as well, all lined up along the wall. Everybody had name tags on.
Actually, a lot more fun than I anticipated. I didn't really know what to walk into as much because we've done Tesla talks and videos, but like talking directly one-on-one, obviously haven't done a lot of. So it was very high-paced,
Yeah,
very fast.
it was funny because when I was standing in line before that first one, I was just waiting for my turn, and I don't know what it reminds me of something. I don't know, like back in grade school or something when you have to like go up on stage or do a speech or something. So I was a little nervous at first, but we know everything about these cars, but I don't have as much experience before yesterday with the Model 3, even though I had picked one up Friday. All I did was drive it home, put it in the garage. So I didn't even go through the screens, and a lot of those screens have changed since we first were driving it back in November of last year. So I was a little nervous because it's like I don't know where some of these settings are. And we did find that as the day went on, that some of the cars were configured differently, and so I didn't know where some of those settings were. But anyways, I was a little nervous before we got started, but I just took basically the script that Derek had used with us the day before, and I started out and took my first new buyer out, and we started out with the app was the first thing we would look at.
So, like, how many deliveries did you do?
I lost count. It was, it was a busy day, and
It was.
I lost count. I kept track of the first four or five, and then I lost count. But I had probably about a dozen Model 3s, and then I had two Model S's. One of them was a CPO Model S, 2015, and the other one was, I don't know how new it was, but it was a 75D that another Model S owner was just trading in his older Model S for that 75D.
Nice. Yeah, I did actually one Model X and then a ton of Model 3s. I kind of lost track. I did actually do the delivery for Kimball Musk.
Yeah, that was
It
cool.
was really awesome. I got to go through the app, make sure everything was figured out for him, go over some settings.
It was cool because we were just going to go out to talk with him, and he was heading out to his car, and we thought we didn't know what he was doing. And then he turned around and was like, "Connor, who had introduced
Connor
us?"
was there.
So he introduced us, saying that we'd been helping with deliveries, and he's like, "Go ahead and give me the spiel or whatever." And he wanted, and we're like, "Oh, okay." And Eric went ahead and did the entire delivery for Kimball. So that
Yeah,
was cool.
it was beyond awesome. But Kimball, we would love you to come sign our Powerwalls if you're
Yeah,
listening.
yeah.
Yeah, that would be kind of
There's
cool.
plenty of room on though.
Yes, there's plenty of room. But yeah, it was just an awesome experience. All the owners were super excited. One couple wore matching t-shirts. So we did a bunch of photos. It was just so much fun to see everybody out
It
there.
was cool because there were all different people. I mean, there were older couples, there were younger couples, there were people who had already owned Model S's, Model X's. There were people who had never even driven a Tesla before, or some had driven a Model S as a test drive. Others had never even been in a Model 3 or seen one before. All different people. Some people brought their dogs out. I mean, there was a big poodle out there. All different people. It was just amazing to see the variety of different customers that showed up. And we got started early in their day, and there wasn't much of a line, but as the day progressed, more and more people showed up for those appointments, and it was just nonstop. The day flew by. I mean, we were there for 12 hours, and it flew by. Well, the first 11 hours flew by. That last hour was getting a little tired there.
Yeah, it was funny. We actually signed up for helping out for about 2 hours from 10 to noon. And I didn't even look down to my phone and saw it was 3 p.m.
Yeah.
So the time flew. And the next thing you know, it was 9 p.m. We hadn't even eaten. Luckily, they had some drinks they were providing and everything. Yeah. But, like, all the Tesla employees were super helpful, too.
It's cool, yeah, yeah.
Everybody was really understanding,
everybody was
too,
just running, so that was, yeah. And everybody was just running around getting, you know, trying to work as fast as they could. I was putting people's license plates on their cars. Like, hey, this is
yeah,
fun.
Yeah, kind of fun.
I was like, I thought you had to be an employee to do that, but we were helping out. We were doing anything that we could. And,
yeah.
And it was cool because we were so busy. I only saw Eric a few times. We were in this one parking lot in the building the entire day, but yeah. I only saw Eric, you know, like half a dozen times all day long because we were just both busy with deliveries all day long. I ran to him when I had some questions about some of the interface in the Model 3 if I couldn't find one of the settings, and then you know, or to borrow a screwdriver or something like that. But other than that, we were busy all day long.
Yeah.
So I went up to these customers who were waiting, and I checked to see if their car was already showing up in the Tesla app for them. Mm-hmm. For most of those that I helped out, the car was already in there, and they had the location available. So I was able to see where their car was on the lot. I would run over, find their car, talk to the detailers, and ask them how much longer on this. Or I would talk with the Tesla employees who were sending out all the orders of which cars to move.
Yeah.
And we would get an ETA of like, okay, 10 more minutes. Otherwise, that car might have sat there for another hour while they were working on their other cars. So it was cool that I was able to go track down those cars, run back to the customers, and tell them, okay, it's 10, 15 minutes. There were a couple cars, though, throughout the day that they did not have the mobile app access enabled, so that had been disabled, and so we had no idea where those cars were. And it seems like the first one was like a midnight silver metallic, and that was like probably the most popular color, or blue.
Yeah, there yesterday. Were so many blues.
And so it's like, okay, and then I would go out there, and there's like eight of them, and it's like, okay, I would have to run from one car to the next and try to check the VIN, check the wheels, and that helped me narrow down which one to get to. And then you know, again, I would go back to the buyer and let them know where their car was at in the process, and it was going to be another 10, 15 minutes. Did have one, though, that mobile access was turned off, and I went around the entire lot. It was nighttime. I don't know, it was like 8 o'clock. Could not find this car. I kept checking everywhere. I checked the detailing bays, checked the car wash, checked every single spot on the lot. It was nowhere to be found. Finally found out it was in the service center. They had moved it inside, and that explained why I couldn't find it. But we finally found that guy his car, and he was that one of those Model S's that I helped with the delivery for.
It was a really fun day. There was a lot of other members from Denver Tesla Club out. Yep.
Thanks to all you guys, too.
Yeah.
Some of them were there even longer than us. They got there right before us, and it's a couple of friends we've seen at Bandimere. We've actually raced against them in their performance Model 3. And we saw other people that we've seen up at you know, Park Meadows events, or even up at the Sound of Silence up in South Dakota. So it was cool to see a lot of old friends that we've made over the years.
Yeah, and a lot of new friends. It was really cool.
Yeah, yeah.
A bunch of you guys actually came up to us and were like, watch your channel, like, can we get a picture? Yeah. That was actually kind of fun. And I got to do actually a delivery for some fans, so that was really cool. It was really fun.
Didn't you say he was like in the car and the buyer was doing like a Skype call or
something? Yeah, I was in the car and a gentleman and his wife were FaceTiming their son, and their son was like, who's that in the car with you? And they actually watched my videos. It was pretty cool. But again, there's just so many cool new owners. Everyone, thank you again for being understanding. So many cars. We don't have an exact count yet, but it was between 200 and 300 probably.
Yeah.
In one day.
Yeah.
One day, so that was just nuts.
And we had heard, we were out there on Friday when they were busy, when we were picking up this Model 3, and we had heard that they had set a record, too, that in the entire country, that Littleton location had done the most deliveries in one day. And this is just in Colorado, but in Colorado, there are no other Tesla stores or no other delivery centers. This is the only Tesla location within, like, 600 miles, so people were coming from all over the state and from other states to pick up their Teslas.
We had people from Durango
come
all the way up.
Grand Junction, all over. I even saw one from New Mexico. So just people from all over the western states were coming. This is the location you had to be at. They did set up another temporary location up in Broomfield, up in northwest Denver area, Denver metro area. So they were doing deliveries up there as well.
Yeah.
So they did set up some temporary locations, but it's just amazing how many people came. And one thing that I was really impressed with is all these cars that I helped with, I did not see a single one that noticed any sort of like alignment issues or door trim issues. And, you know, I know in the past, last year when they were first ramping up, there were a few issues and people got some things that they put on their due bill. I did not see a single issue like that yesterday. There were a couple people that were concerned about just, you know, like fingerprints or some smudges and stuff, or door or polish from when they were doing the detailing. And so we, you know, get some rags and wipe that off. But other than that, I mean, the body and the cars looked great. And this, they did have the service center open and open late.
Yeah.
I mean, we were there until like 10:30, and they were still working on, for some of the cars that did have minor issues, they could run them back there and mm-hmm. take care of those, like a charge port, you know, the lid or the door not staying closed or something. But it was just very minor stuff like that.
Yeah, it was really awesome to see. Again, huge thanks to all you Tesla employees. Thank you, Tesla. It was really fun to be able to volunteer our time, and 12 hours has never gone by faster.
Flew by. I don't work that much at my current job. You know, I can't remember last time if I ever put in a 12-hour day. So that was just, it flew by. It was fun.
Yeah, it was so much fun. Really happy that we could actually help out and kind of return the favor that Tesla has been able to give us.
It was a very special experience being able to be part of yesterday. That was probably one of the most momentous days in Tesla history so far.
Yeah.
I'm sure every quarter this has been the most important, the most deliveries ever. And we were there. We were part of it. Today's probably another big day around the country, or Sunday the 30th is a big day for other parts of the United States. But in Colorado, that was the big day. And I don't know, it'll be interesting to see if that happens again at the end of the fourth quarter.
Yeah.
Because they're still going to be continuing to ramp up that Model 3 production and still selling a lot of Model S and Model Xs as well. So to commemorate this momentous Tesla event, we're going to be doing another little giveaway. We happen to have one of these little Model 3s that they gave away to some of the owners a while back. And we're going to give one of these away to one of our lucky viewers.
Yep.
Anywhere in the world, this one, I think we can, this one is safe that we can ship. It's not a battery, so no problem sending this to anyone in the world if you are one of our subscribers.
Yeah, so what we'll do, we'll go ahead and post a quick snapshot on Instagram. And just go like that photo. Make sure you're a subscriber on here. Make sure you follow me on Instagram. And we're going to go ahead and pick one of you guys to get this, and then we'll go ahead and ship it wherever in the world you are. We will send this to you. So yeah, just a huge thank you to everybody. Model 3 is really kind of what's really making all this happen.
Yep.
So couldn't be more excited. But yeah, I guess that's basically it for this one. Hopefully you guys enjoyed a little bit of story time and some experiences. It was such a fun time. We wanted to be able to share that with you guys. As always though, if you're looking for a Tesla, definitely check out our website, teslainventory.com. If you're looking for a new or inventory Model S or X, or even a performance Model 3, feel free to use our referral code. It's down in the description below and at the top of our website. Using it will actually get you a $100 supercharging credit, which is great if you go on any road trips or anything, so you don't have to even worry about it. And if you do use it, definitely send us an email through the website so that we have your contact info, so when we take delivery of our next-gen Roadsters, we can invite you guys out, do some test drives, because really, all your support, none of this would be possible, and we can't thank you guys enough. As always, though, thumbs up if you enjoyed that video. Go ahead and click here to subscribe, here for some other ones. We'll see you guys in the next one. We'll